Can you see over here? Should I go in here?
Yes.
Is this better? Yeah, the spotlight's right there. Thank you. Thank you. I'm so honored to be opening the speeches on this glorious day. My name is Josh, and some of you may know me as Josh from the Josh and Pete Band. For those who don't know, that's Pete of the Josh and Pete Band. I have been Pete's best friend since the year 2000, and boy, have we been through a lot together. Pete and I went to high school together. We were in a band together. Then we went to camp together. Then college together. Then another band together. Then we lived in the same house after college together for 4 years. Then we were in another band together. Then we went into business together. Some of you thought, I wonder if Pete and Josh are gonna get married together. Nope. Unless you'd reconsider. No, I'm just kidding. But as his original life partner, I've seen Pete through the best and worst moments of his life. But one thing that I always had for Pete was belief in him. You see, Pete had this deeply special creativity, this vulnerable eccentricity, this wondrous artistry that I believed was a gift to the world. He spent a long time thinking that perhaps this gift was a curse, as sometimes it can be lonely for a really special artist. But I never stopped believing that it was truly a gift. Things took some time to work out for Pete in his life, but when they did, it would always be magnificent. I watched Pete for a long time, loving and learning. He often felt deflated, like there was not someone out there that would get him like I got him. But I knew that this person existed, and I knew that not only would that person get him, but that person would be magical because he was a freaking unicorn. And whoever he met, his perfect match would be a unicorn too. Side note, Serena was literally wearing a unicorn costume when Pete proposed to her. I met Serena 5 years ago, and Serena and I took a Jewish leadership course together. It was the right time and right place kind of thing. Both of us considered ourselves Jewish light, but something about the entrepreneurship stuck out to us, and we took a chance on it. We instantly bonded, and I thought to myself, this person has the same beautiful gift as Pete. This is the person for Pete. Operation Get Pete and Serena in the Same Room commenced, and from there it did not take much to get the two connecting on a creative level. The first time they hung out, they were matching each other's energies, playing a silly improv game together in the kitchen unprompted. I remember the first thing Pete said about Serena was that he was impressed. This was the highest praise coming from Pete, who is very hard to impress. I watched Pete be the best version of himself through this relationship, exploring what it means to be a partner. The relationship has inspired so much creativity, fun, imagination, love. They really bring out the best in each other. But what really sticks out is their ability to nurture that vulnerability in each other's gifts and build each other up to the most spectacular versions of each other. Pete and I had a running theme in our relationship that I always experienced life first, and that he was always a few years behind. But he'd catch up eventually. On my wedding day to the lovely Rachel, Pete, during his speech to me, stood there and said, "You're showing me how to find the woman of your dreams and spend the rest of your life with her. I can't even fathom that." Well, look at you now, Pete. Serena, Pete found you, the woman of his dreams, and not only can he fathom that now, but every day for the rest of your lives, anything you imagine for yourselves, you have the gift to create together.
All right, for our second toast, I'd like to pass that microphone and invite up front Marsden. Can you show Marsden some love?
Yeah, I didn't write anything. I'm gonna put this down. Hi, good evening. That spilled. Really good start. There's still some left. I am honored to speak to you both tonight. Like, really honored. Josh is a tough act to follow up. Oh, I did prepare something. I first met Pete in Mrs. Hallis's social studies class in seventh grade at Cedarbrook Middle School. I don't quite remember any conversations that we had, but I do remember making up terrible raps and evident sounds in the back of class with one Eli Katz. Based on his seating at the lunch table, I thought he was one of the cool, popular kids, and that couldn't have been farther from the truth. While there were some additional interactions in those younger days, like choir with Mr. Monath and feeling legs for hair, if you recall, hair. We didn't really become very close friends until the summer before junior year of high school. This was around the time that the Josh and Pete band was in full swing, and we birthed an a cappella singing group as a side hustle to, quote, get girls at parties, which didn't work. But it did become a full-fledged, semi-professional singing group. Who would have thought? Still can't believe that people paid a bunch of 16-year-olds a lot of money to sing a terrible 30-minute set. From there, it was all Duke Duke Womp Womps and Bebop Arebops, American Beauties, Locatelli Cheese Wheels, pasta with a full stick of butter, thank you, Seth, Steakums Cheeseics with cheesesteaks without any cheese, Flavor Blast Goldfish, and licking fries so the salt sticked. AP Environmental Title Power presentations with no actual content, drinking 2-liter bottles of soda and heading home to Andy and Vinny's every day during high school for lunch to watch Nick Jr. shows like Blue's Clues and Dora the Explorer. We were really mature. Back in the tin, junior prom, New York kidnappings, going to the beach in a shed, Purim's pet portraits, and some pot. From Cheltenham to Penn State to Israel to Philly to now Baltimore, I have to say I am extremely lucky and fortunate to have you in my life. In fact, all of the DiLorenzos have really been a family to me. You know that? We've had countless great times, and we've been through the really, really hard times together. When you first introduced me to Serena, I knew two things. One, you'd struck gold. And two, I instantly had a new lifelong friend. Serena, you're fantastic. I could go on and on, but I think everybody knows how special you are and how special you two are together. I'm really, really happy for you both. Love you. Mazel tov.
Coming up next to the microphone, make some noise for Joanna.
Thank you. Serena and I met in the ninth grade, so we have had a lot of time to discuss the ideals of partnership together. It might have started as a MASH layout in the middle of our math notes somewhere, but eventually developed into a little bit more sophisticated of conversation over a glass of wine in our sweatpants, obviously. A few months before Serena met Pete, we had a conversation like this, and she said something that stuck out to me as so oddly specific. She said, "I just want to spend my life with someone that I can be super playful with, someone creative that centers silliness in our home." And Serena, I'm so sorry that didn't work out for you. Pete, I am also happy tonight to offer you my blessing on your nuptials, but there is some unfinished business we need to attend to. You see, thanks to the powers vested in us by Facebook.com, Serena and I actually have already been married. It's a little confusing because we had previously declared ourselves sisters in the ninth grade when we realized we could share all of our clothes and it would be like two closets for life. But, you know, in the oppressive patriarchal moment of Facebook relationship statuses in the early 2000s, we did choose each other. So tonight, in my toast to the happy couple, Serena, I officially Facebook divorce you. Yeah. Pete, I couldn't have done it for a less deserving person, obviously. Serena, I will happily now reinstall myself for sister duties. And I have a barbecue next weekend, so I'm assuming I can borrow that dress. Cheers, I love your love.
Well said, Johanna. Next up, I'd like to invite up here, she's already ready, Tara. Make some noise for Tara, ladies and gentlemen.
Hi, guys. Serena. I've known Serena since we were literally like this big. Right? We ones. You two are just absolutely perfect together. And what not a... What would be a perfect way to celebrate today? A musical toast.
Asking me where I love grow. Yes,
Something in the way they groove. They laugh, they dance, they are Sarita. Don't you wish you were that cool? They're making a pact today that forever their hearts will stay.
For the ladies one more time. That is an amazing tradition. My hat off to you all. Next up, I'd like to invite up Serena's dad and stepmom, Bob and Cheryl, to grab the microphone.
Yikes, this is really hard to follow. I can see. Serena and Pete, this is a thrilling moment. I think you both know that early on in your relationship, you both made it to the top, to the list of a lot of people's top five best couples. And most of them are here today, I'm sure. And that's because you're such a great example of what a fun, loving, respectful, and committed relationship can look like. We love you and we celebrate you today. And this is a great and fabulous occasion.
So I decided to write a little poem for you guys. So, to write a poem about Serena and Pete is by any standards a challenging feat. To capture their flair in a stanza or two, harder than explaining the joy of bacon to an Orthodox Jew. The joining of Pete and Serena, what a joy to discover, two lovely trees of the forest that have found one another. Their leaves, branches, roots, flowers, an enticing song that invites us all to just want to come along. What can one say to illuminate their essence, the beat, the swagger, the jive of their presence? They were singing, dancing, communing, and shit, and skits. That's the next line. Gushing over their cat gravy, even when she shits. They create a panache of, hang on, of inspired renditions like the music and scenes from their birthday auditions, and their over-the-top creativity is at your disposal, like Pete's otherworldly marriage proposal. They gather friends not by effort nor will, but from the warmth, caring, and depth they instill. And these friends are a boatload of wildness and joy, a community of ahs with very few oys. Their joining is a merengue, a samba, a tango, sweet like a peach or a juicy mango. And when life's stressors raise their challenging shackles that can sometimes feel like country blues cackles, they can sit their sweet butts right in the middle of it and imbibe its melody with courage and grit, supporting each other in what is most precious and real. Honoring and respecting what they discover and feel. They rival Mickey and Minnie Mouse for their charm and mirth. Ours accepting as Shrek and Fiona, but with a lot less girth. Can Fred and Wilma Flintstone outdo them in allure? Can Popeye and Olive Oil claim they love each other more? When our granddaughter Ava first saw them together, she at once knew they were birds of a feather. It was simple, she said, to understand the Serena. It was obvious that Pete was the male version of Serena. When true goodness recognizes itself in another, a blessing arises in the heart of each other, a mutual expression of virtue and care that is effortlessly expressed and so naturally shared that it spreads beyond their personal bond like ripples on a sunlit pond, enhancing all those who come into their sphere, surely way more intoxicating than booze or beer. Well, there's so much more I can offer to say, but it would take hours to recant, maybe even a day. So why ramble on and on beating their drum when just hanging out with them is so much more fun? Love you guys.
Well said, Bob and Cheryl. Show them some love. We got one more group coming up for our final toast, so show some love to Pete's parents and brothers, Vinny, Andy, Seth, and Jamie.
Hello. Sir Peter. We would like to honor you and give you a four-dimensional toast. We want to honor you as an entertainer, as a creator, a giver, and a dreamer.
The entertainer. My third son have always been my sweetie Petey. Petey Pie, Petey Pie of Pieland. He was so adorable and entertained me from the first moment that I saw your beautiful face and platinum blonde hair and your voice saying, I'm starving. You never saw a kid that ate so much. And look at him. My mother called him a long drink of water. You've entertained me from your Halloween costumes you used to love to get dressed up in, the school plays, when you were Teddy Roosevelt, charge, in Arsenic and Old Lace, the horny king in the Purim plays. Stunning.
Stunning.
And then there was the music, your guitar playing, your singing, your four cute guys, BYOB, Josh and Pete Band, the Really Cooks. Loved watching you. It was just a joy. You've always been an entertainer. And Serena, you've been an entertainer. How lucky that you both found each other where you could share your talents. And my wish for you is that you can always make beautiful music together.
Pete, I've known you for a very long time. And I have never met anyone with so much creativity flowing through him as I have you, Pete. Like, it's it's amazing to see. It's really, it's not easy to do, and you make it so effortless. And even your schedules, where you're down to the minute, are bursting with imagination and creativity. But then there is Serena. Siriri Shapipi, you know? This wonderful, wonderful woman that brings out the best in Pete even more so, and Pete, you, to Serena. And when you two come together, you get this. Like, I have never been to anything like this in my entire life, and... the amount of creativity that you bring to things and that you share, your expression of how you do things is so amazing to share with everyone here. And I am in awe of how you express those things and how effortlessly it comes to you and how meaningful it is to everyone that you share it with. And it's truly a gift that you guys have, that you are willing to share with everyone.
And I'm gonna echo that. Pete, I met you the very first day you were born. That was an incredible day. And every single day since then, I have just felt tremendous love and joy and wonderment coming from you. And Serena, I met you shortly after Serpita was born, and every single day since then, I have felt tremendous joy, love, and wonderment coming from you. And I'm sure everybody here in this room could tell a story about how either one of you or both of you together just stirred up something special, either with somebody or just in front of them. And you each have this energy and together this synergy, this alchemy. As Pijo said, you just access the magic. You know how to get it. And all you want to do is share it with everyone you meet. And that's what I call generosity.
I was there too, Pete, when you were born, so. I helped a little bit in getting this thing together, so. So, Pete, you've always been a dreamer, you know? You've dreamed that you want to be a great artist, a great musician, a songwriter, a singer, an actor, and you're doing so well in obtaining these goals and those levels of achievement. You know, but you've always been dreaming about finding true love. You know, you've always been out there saying, I want my soulmate, you know? And it was very interesting because a number of years ago, you invited us to a forum for youth leadership, okay? And you know, you guys, we figured you'd be, you know, the forum spiel, you guys were, you know, promoting it and everything. But I think the real thing that you wanted us to do was to take a look at this girl who is going to be presenting that day as well. Her name is Serena Shapiro with an E. And, you know, we just knew that this was something that we had to get involved with because we're very nosy as parents. So we just really needed to see this through. So it was, we went to that day, and believe it or not, Cheryl of the Bob and Cheryl Band was there as well. We didn't know each other, but she was there as well. And we struggled listening for these couple hours, you know, pretty boring stuff. And up comes this young woman, tall, beautiful, poised, confident, came up the steps and went to the podium and said, "Hey everybody, I'm Serena Shapiro," with an E. And we listened to the talk, and at the end of the talk, we go, wow, you know, not only is she everything we just thought about and told ourselves about, but she was so smart. You know, we said, Pete, what a catch this girl's gonna be, all right? And, you know, it went from there, all right? We said, please God, let this be the one. And we all know what came after that. So we're all here for that. So, Serena, I really want to welcome you to our family. And we are so proud and happy to be part of this family over here because they're pretty cool too. And all of us wish you lifetime of only good things. May you have peace, happiness, love, prosperity, good health, and probably the most important thing, great sex. All right, we got a crowd here. We got a crowd here. So we know where everybody's places are in here. And finally, one last thing. Don't ever, 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 ever stop dreaming. L'chaim.
I lied. We have one more thing we need to take care of before we get to the dancing. Ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna pass the microphone on to Pete and Serena. They wanted to make sure to say thank you to each and every person in here.
Thanks, everybody. We're just like so overwhelmed. This is unbelievable. I'm sure everyone's ready to dance and move, so we're gonna try to work through this quick. Yeah, this is amazing.
First, this is so ridiculously incredible to see everybody in the same room. This is literally like the most important people in our lives all together. And we're just like feeling the energy and feeling the love. So give yourselves a hand for being here.
We want to thank Josh and Marsden and Joanna and Tara and the whole crew of girls, Kelly, Victoria, Claire, Lily, for doing that amazing song, and my dad and Cheryl and Andy and Vinny and Seth and Jamie for the amazing toasts. We want to thank Charlotte for helping us plan and coordinate this whole shindig tonight. She's a rock star. And we wouldn't have been able to do any of this with her or our dear friend and her husband, Dave, who has also been phenomenal in helping. We want to thank Kara and everyone at Blue Pit for the amazing food you guys had tonight. And Kara has just been phenomenal in this whole process. She knows weddings inside and out and just has been such an amazing additional support. And let's not forget the amazing bartenders. Please tip them in the back for getting us all the good drinks.
Want to thank our amazing DJ, Sean Jay, from Mixing Maryland. He's been creating all the amazing vibes and everything that you hear tonight. Just wait till we get to the dance party, because that's going to be something else. We want to thank Jess and Will and everyone at the 2640 space for helping us out in so many ways with this magical venue that you're sitting in right now. It's truly a special spot for special people. I want to thank Ian and Colin, and who are insanely talented videographers. These guys are going to make this whole night like a cinematic masterpiece. So don't be shy. Bust out your best moves. And maybe you'll make the final cut of the movie.
We want to thank our friend Chris for providing all the phenomenal lighting equipment you see, and the amazing Jason up here who's operating it all, making the mood so freaking epic, donating so many more hours of his time to make this amazing. Thank you so much. We want to thank Pijo and Scott, our loves, our officiants, our elders, our second parents. We love you both so much. It was just so meaningful to have you bear witness to this moment with all of us and work with us on this. Yeah, and that's all I got. I want to thank the incredible Miss Sarah Lederer for making me the most phenomenal flower jacket. If any of you were at our house last night, she's insanely talented, and no one has made me feel more beautiful ever.
Wanted to give a shout out to Kristen, who couldn't be here tonight because of our newborn nephew, Phoenix. They're both very missed, and we are just so excited to be his aunt and uncle. And lastly, we'd love to thank all the wonderful, last of this page. We want to thank all of the wonderful friends who came and helped us out yesterday setting up this place, because this entire wedding was DIY. Like, we built it from the ground up, and everybody has been such a huge help in getting this all together.
Yeah, tremendous, tremendous help. We want to thank Corinne, our wonderful photographer, who's so talented, gonna make everyone look so good. And it's also her birthday tonight. So everybody, get her a drink at the bar. And we have other birthdays this week. Today is also our dear friend Dan Campbell's birthday. This week we had birthdays from our friend Emily Mullen, our amazing niece Ava, our nephew Little Zoe, our aunt Leslie, and Petey, whose birthday strikes at midnight tonight. Oh. And last but not least, we want to thank our families for making this so, so meaningful and incredible. Tell them about it. Seriously, like, everything from dancing down the aisle to supporting us nonstop through everything and just being like really incredibly generous and wonderful. And we love y'all so much.